All right, so my October coloring pages. There are not as many as last month, which is expected, since last month was kind of crazy. I have about 10 finished, I think. Let's see, let me just put that over there, and then keep this over here. Yeah, so I'll start with the one that's not in a book. So this is Rita Berman's Autumn Special, and she had it for free to download on her Instagram page. And I printed it out on black paper, again, the same as I did with Milly Melorta's Whale last month. And you can see the ink, maybe down here it says her, I think it's like a copyright. But I mean, you can see, you can kind of see the ink, but it's quite hard. I mean, the whole reason why I printed it on this paper is it was the only paper that's a bit more... better quality than what normal print paper that I have. So yeah, but anyway, yeah, this was fun. It was done with Polychromos, Derwent Drawing, and there's some water-based marker in the dark parts of the background. I think, let's see if I put it like that, maybe. And this was quite difficult. It was more difficult than the whale from last month, because the whale from Milly Melorta's style has more patterns, so I could just go over the patterns with the pencils. But here I had to more, you know, like color it. And... yeah, so I went with like choosing different light sources, and I'm not quite... I mean, it's fine, but I have like, you know, the stars up here are casting one light on the clouds, and then I have the lantern, the window, the door, the candle here, and then the hedgehog sort of disappeared, so I had to, you know, sort of invent a light source for him, but he shouldn't really be that lit up, but okay. Yeah, it was fun. I think, yeah, and it's a bit, it's hard to see all the details, especially like, I mean, even in real life, but especially on camera. Let's see, I'll put this over here. Next up, we have a fun one I did in Botanicum. This is water-based markers with pencils on top. Quite harsh. I had to press a lot on this page. You can sort of see all the wax bloom there. And this is Polychromosaur, it's not even Prismacolors. But yeah, it was fun. I covered up the ghosts, I didn't really like them. The bat is sort of disappearing a bit, but I think that's part of the... Like, bats are supposed to be dark. And yeah, I like how this turned out. Not my best work, not my worst work. It was fine. I'm not sure I like the candles, but well. Let's see, that was Botanicum. And then we have... Oh, where am I even going to put these? okay, I'll put it here. Okay. Next up we have in Sorcier. I did study like maybe 8 years of French. So you would think I know a bit more than I do, but I really don't. But you know how it is with languages. It's one thing to learn a language in school and another thing to actually speak it and use it. But yeah, I finished this one. This was a whip for a long time from it's from last year, but still. And I had done most of it. I just had to go in and do the background. And the background is done with Lyra water crayons, and then smoothed over with pencil, and yeah, I like it. It was fun. Yeah, let's see, I said I would put them over here. The memory. Yeah, and then in October, right? Yeah, October is the month. I went to visit my parents, and I only took with me 3 books. This Tales from the Witch's Cottage, and then a mythographic book, and the Mouse Guard. And I only colored out of Tales of the Witch's Cottage. So there's a lot in here that I colored. First up is the cats. And I finished this before I left, actually. So this was a whip last month, if you remember. I had to... smooth over the red cat, the devil cat, and yeah, this is I'm proud of this. I like how it turned out. I wish I had a bit more of this blue glow on, you see on the fence there, there's a bit of the blue glow. I wish I had more of it because there's a lot of orange glow on this side. So it would be a bit more fair to the angel cat if he had a bit more glowing. But yeah, this is water-based markers, polychromos. There's some stickles in the background. You can maybe see that. And there's a white gel pen, obviously. And I think that's it. Yeah. This was fun. I like doing it, even if this is the technique I called war in my water-based marker technique. So it's quite, you had to press a lot and you have to fight the image and the paper and the marker. You sort of fight it with the pencil. So yeah. It's not something I do a lot, but it's fun when I do. Let's see. Then I have, this was a mindless one, Inktense, Albrecht Dürer, and some other mishmash of watercolor pencils that I borrowed. And oh, and some gel pen, obviously. But yeah, this was just a mindless one. We went up to the mountains, the Slovenian Alps, with my parents, and we were there, the whole family. So that was really nice. This one I finished yesterday, and this was for a color along challenge. It was for the Jamie's Coloring Love, I think. Yep. Okay, so she had the October breakdown prompts of 2021, and I thought sort of did all the four prompts in one. So it was outlaw, costume, timed color, and Halloween theme. So obviously it's a Halloween theme. And I sort of, and I mean, he's in costume, the frog, that's okay. And I timed it, so I colored this in 45 minutes. I did cheat a bit. So like when the timer went, I was halfway through making all the yellow dots, and then I was like, okay, give me like 10 more seconds, and I did the rest of the yellow dots as well. But yeah, the problem is outlaw. But in my head, this frog is obviously an outlaw. This is his sword. He sort of, stole the jewelry box he's sitting on. Yeah, it covers all the prompts in my head, so that's good. But yeah, it was fun. It's not, I mean, obviously, in 45 minutes, it's fine for that. Then we have this one. And the lighting is not doing it justice, but yeah. It was this was a quick one actually. Inktense and other watercolor pencils as a base, and then polychromos on top, and some white gel pen for the weird flying cat. Yeah, I like the colors. Not sure I like how I did the cat. Oh, I have a glare also. Oh well, but not sure I like the how I did the cat. Could have done that better. Oh, there's some golden gel pen as well on her shoes as well. But it was fun. I like doing this. And then we have I feel like there's a no, that's it. Yeah, there's just a mindless work in progress here. So when I was away, I wanted something to just color and fill in. So this is some fine liner, and I still have the bottom part here to do. Oh, and I always make sure when I do like this black backgrounds, I always make sure to use like, a waterproof fine liner. Sure, it's not the best on the nib, and these fine liners maybe should be used for more because they're quite expensive. They should be used maybe should. Maybe be used for, I don't know, tracing something, some artwork or whatever. But the reason why I use these is because they're waterproof, as I said. So I can go and actually color these tidbits with some water media without being concerned about the black tainting the image and flowing, with the water. So yeah, that's it for Tales from the Witch's Cottage. Then we have, this is so going to fall over here. Okay. Then we have in Luna, I think this is the mindless one. Exactly. So this is a mindless Maria Trolle image, and I don't really like how it turned out, but it's fine. It's fine. It has some golden gel pen, and this is done with the scribbly method, and then there's some green polychromos in the background. And yeah, I mean, it's something. I think what I don't like is the I want to say the color combo, but yeah, it's probably the color combo that I don't like, but I can't really tell you what exactly about it. I think it's the green, but no, maybe it's the pink. It's usually the pink that bothers me in images. As I said before, like, pink has a tendency to like creep into my pictures, and I like pink, it's not that, but it's a really powerful color and it sort of takes over. But yeah, that was mindless. Water-based markers, polychromos, and gel pen. And then we have from Secrets of the Sea by Milly Marotta. I got this book because I got it from Milly for a competition, and that was really fun. So I colored this one, and it's just mindless. Water-based markers, yellow Posca, and some polychromos, but not a lot. You can sort of, I think maybe you can see in the shine where the pencils are. Maybe not. But yeah, fun, fun, fun. And then we're almost at the end already. we have In Beauty of Horror. This is a work in progress. And it was a forever work in progress, and I've just continued on it. And I have to say this again, it's not finished yet, so it doesn't look good, but it probably will in the end. But right now it looks like, and it's supposed to be a bit psychedelic, but okay, let me just show you this one. So yeah, I love haunted playgrounds. And this is done with water-based markers. It's just the base right now. And I sort of, what I did, the cars were already colored, and the spiders were already colored. The spiders aren't really finished, but yeah. And then I sort of added this weird background. But I thought like, yeah, no, I think I kind of like this idea of like having, you know, the shadows in this way. We'll see how it turns out. It'll probably be fine in the end, it usually is. And lastly, we have a little, this is just a mindless coloring in the miniature, it's probably the Animal Kingdom this is called, but yeah, this is just mindless. It's not finished obviously, but I had colored this one and I sort of continued a bit. And yeah, fine liners and some white Posca. Yeah, that's actually it for this month. Not that much, but I mean, it's still a fair amount. And yeah, we'll see what I do next month.